So now we shall see how to construct the same binary counter by using D flip-flops. Okay, so the thing is, so here there's a cache, like so first we need to convert the D flip-flop to T flip-flop. So here we have constructed, the previous video we have constructed a binary counter by using T flip-flop. That is fine, we are done with that. So now we are supposed to construct the same binary counter by using D flip-flop. The thing is, what they are given here is, so next we will redesign the binary counter to use D flip-flop instead of T flip-flops. Okay, the easiest way to do this is to convert each D flip-flop to T flip-flop. So the easiest way to construct the binary counter by using D flip-flop is by converting the D flip-flop to T flip-flop. Okay, how to convert the D flip-flop to T flip-flop. So we have studied the same thing in the previous chapter of flip-flops. This is how you're supposed to convert the conversion of D to T. Okay, so the same thing I have written here. So this is D flip-flop. How does the D flip-flop is going to work? If I'm going to pass 0, the output will be 0. If I'm going to pass 1, the output will be 1. The same thing. If I'm passing 0, the output is 0. If I'm passing 1, the output will be 1. So no matter whatever might be the present state. Whatever the data which you are going to pass now, that will be the next state. The same thing. So forget about the present state. Okay. Least bother about the present state. What is present within the flip-flop? Whatever it might be, okay. With respect to D flip-flop, whatever data you are going to pass, if you are passing 0, the output is 0. If you are passing 1, the output is 1. If you are passing 0, the output is 0. If you are passing 1, the output is 1. This is how the D flip-flop is going to work. Okay. So now we are supposed to convert this, D flip-flop to T flip-flop. How to convert this D to T now? So we can do this by adding an XOR gate. And one of this input for this XOR gate is the output of the flip-flop. Okay. So write it as T. Okay. See. So let me assume if it is 0. Right now the present state, this flip-flop containing 0. So what is Q now? Q is also 0. If Q is 0, the input will be 0. So let me assume T is equal to 1. If T is 1, 1 and 0, this is an XOR gate. Okay, this is an XOR gate. I have written the XOR gate table here, true table. Okay. So the input for this XOR gate is 1 and 0. So how does this XOR gate is work? If the inputs are same, the output is 0. If the inputs differs, 0, 1 and 1, 0, the output is 1. Inputs same idre, output 0 agutte. Input different idre, 0, 1, 1, 0, athara different agidre, the output 1 barutte. Clear? If the inputs are same, 0, 0 or 1 and 1, the output is 0, 0. If the input differs, like 0, 1 and 1, 0, the output is 1 and 1. So this is how the XOR gate is work. This is the XOR gate. Okay. So right now the input is 1 and 0. So if 1 and 0, the output is 1. So now the output of this XOR gate is 1. If I am passing this 1 into this flip-flop, so this 0 will be converted to 1 now. So now the Q will be 1. Okay. Next, Q I am going to pass 1 here. So again, let me take T is equal to. So I am passing 1, the output is 1. Similarly, okay, passing 1, the output is 1. So though this flip-flop is D, I am converting it to T. Even after converting it to T, still it is working as a D flip-flop. Okay, so don't get confused. So now it is 1. So let me assume 1. 1 and 1 with respect to XOR gate. 1 and 1 is 0. So now I am passing 0. If I am passing 0, the output, this 1 will be converted to 0. So again it will be 0. So if I am passing 1, it will be 0. One and one is zero, right? If I'm passing zero, the output will be zero. If I'm passing zero, the output will be zero. This is how it is going to work. Okay. this is how the D flip-flop is to be converted to T flip-flop. Okay. So now the whole working is like a T. How? Let me tell it once again. Let me show it's working once again, wait. Let me assume right now the flip-flop containing 0. Okay, now the input is 0. So if you take T is equal to 1, okay, T is 1. Okay, so look at the truth table. If T is 1, if the present state is 0, the right now the present state is 0, T is 1. So what should be the output? The output should be 1. So out. So look at here, the present state is 0. So now I am passing T is equal to 1. If t is equal to 1 and the present state is 0, the output should be 1. This is what the T flip-flop is going to tell. So, but this is XOR gate. If I am passing 1 and 0 with respect to XOR gate, the output is 1. The output is 1. So, if I am passing 1 into D flip-flop, this 0 will be converted to 1. So, now Q will be 1. The output is 1, right? What you wanted? The output is 1. You got the same thing. Okay. So let me take, now the Q is 0, T is 0, so the present state is, let me assume 0 itself, present state is 0, so if this is 0, Q will be 0, if this is 0, this will be 0, now I am passing 0 as a T input, present state is 0, I am passing 0, present state is 0, look at here, I am passing 0, present state is 0, the output should be 0. So 0 and 0 with respect to XOR gate is 0. So I am writing 0 here. So if this is 0, it will be 0 itself. I got the same 0. Okay, right now, if you take just this like this, this thing, this is D flip-flop. If I am adding XOR gate, this is going to, the whole thing is converted to T flip-flop. Getting? So now, what I am supposed to do is, the circuit should look like a T flip-flop, but it has to work like a D flip-flop now. So the thing, what it was working now is, this is D flip-flop, by adding an XOR gate, this is converted to T flip-flop, and it is working as T flip-flop itself. Ilena agide, D flip-flop use maadkondidivi, XOR gate use maadkonde, ಅದು ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪಿಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಯಿತು. ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಗ ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್ ಥರನೇ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಈಸ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್, ನಾಟ್ ಟಿ. ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಿದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಡಿ. ಇದು ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪು, ಅದನ್ನು ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪಿಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ. ಈಗ ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಇದು ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್ ಥರನೇ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಅದು ನಮಗೆ ಯಾವ ಥರ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು? ನಮಗೆ ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್ ಥರ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್ ಥರ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು? ಬಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ಎ ಬೈನರಿ ಕೌಂಟರ್ ಬೈ ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್. ಓಕೆ, ಬಟ್ ದೋ ದಿಸ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್, ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ವರ್ಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್, ವಾಟ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಡೂ? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ನೌ. ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್? ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್, ರೈಟ್ ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್. ಇಫ್ we want the whole circuit to work as D flip-flop, means we need to fix the value of T here. So we need to fix the value of T is equal to 1. This can't be 0. If T is always 1, the whole thing is going to work as D now. Let me show how. Let me assume this T is always 1. Okay, it's fixed. Right now we have 0. Okay, 0 is passed here, 0. 1 and 0 with respect to XOR Z, 1 and 0 with respect to XOR gate is 1. So 1. Okay. So if it this is 1, what will be the flip flop? This will be 1. Okay. Now next it will be 1. 1 and 1. 1 and 1 is 0. 0. Now it will be 0. If I am passing 0, it will be 0. If I am passing 1, it will be 1. The same. If I am passing 0, it will be 0. If I am passing 1, it will be 1. So the whole thing is a T flip-flop, but it is working as D flip-flop now. What we did? I fixed the value of T to 1. This can't be 0. Okay. If the value of T is 1, if it is fixed, the whole thing is working as a D flip-flop, even though this is a T flip-flop. Getting? So let me see how next, what is supposed to be done. As usual, as we constructed this table for to construct a binary counter with respect to T flip-flop, the same thing has to be done for a D flip-flop. Rather than writing TC, TB, TA, we are supposed to write DC, DB, DA, because here it is T flip-flop, we are supposed to construct now by using D flip-flop. The same thing I have done here. So this is a present state, this is a next state, and this is a DC, DB, DA. So you know that if the input is 0, the output is 0. If the input is 1, the output is 1. The same thing here. So there is no complexity here. If it is 0, this will be 0. If it is 0, if it will be 0. If this is 1, if this will be 1. The same thing, whatever I have written here, this and this is all thing. Why it is same? But the same, this is not, but in case of T flip-flop differs. Why it differs? T flip-flop varies with respect to different inputs, and when, look at here, if it is 0, this is turned to 1 based on the present state. If it is 0, it is 0. If it is 0, then it is possibility of 1. But with respect to D flip-flop, if you are passing 0, the output is 0. If you are passing 1, the output is 1. 0 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 0 ಬರುತ್ತೆ, 1 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 1 ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಡಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಅದೇ ಟಿ ಫ್ಲಿಪ್ ಫ್ಲಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆದರೆ ಆ ಥರ ಅಲ್ಲ. 0 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 0 ಬರ್ಬೋದು, 1 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 1 ಬರ್ಬೋದು, 0 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 1 ಬರ್ಬೋದು, 1 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 0 ಬರ್ಬೋದು. ಬೋತ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಇದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ 0 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ 0 ಬಂತು, ಇಲ್ಲಿ 0 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಿ 1 ಬಂತು, ಇಲ್ಲಿ 1 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 1 ಬಂತು, ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ 1 pass ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 0 ಬಂತು. ಬೋತ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಬಟ್ ಇಯರ್ in case of D flip flop, whatever you pass, the same thing will appear. 0 pass 0 1 1 0 0 1 1. Yeah, the same thing. Whatever you are going to pass, the same thing will be the output with respect to DC, DB, DA. So now you are supposed to construct a KMF for this column DA, DB, and DC. Look at here. This is a DA table, DB table, DC table. So a quad is possible. For this quad, you are going to get A bar. For this two pairs, you are going to get B bar A, B A bar and B bar A. So this can be written as B XOR A. This symbol is there, no? This is, we call it as an XOR. So wherever you find in this format, B A bar and B bar A, or A bar B plus A B bar, like this, A bar B, A B bar, or B A bar, B bar A, this can be written as B XOR A. Okay, so for this one, for this single isolation, you are going to get C bar B A plus C B bar and C A bar. Okay, this is one pair and this is another pair, two pairs and single isolation. This is isolation, two pairs. So what they have done for this is, what they have done for this is, I have written here. The same thing I've written here. C bar B A. So look at here. C B. Look at here. I have taken a common here. C C taken common. B bar A bar I've written here. Getting. So here C bar as it is B A I've written within the bracket. So this C bar within a bracket B A and C B A. This is of the format A bar B and A B bar. So A bar is some, A bar means here it is C bar, B means B A, here A means C, B bar means B A whole bar. So this can be written as C XOR B A. The same thing they are written here, C XOR BA. So now DA is equal to A bar, DB is equal to B XOR A, DC is equal to C XOR BA. The same thing, DA is equal to, so first what they have done is, this is A bar, right? So look at here, what is DA? A bar. So this is D flip flop that is converted to, by using XOR gate, it is converted to D flip flop. So one input is fixed, as I told, to make this whole flip flop to work as D, I am fixing the value of TA is equal to 1. Okay, so one more input is from A bar actually. This connection should be A bar, but it is, we have a printing mistake here. They have taken a connection from A, but actually it is A bar. So A bar means you are supposed to take a connection from A bar, from this here. Okay, A bar. Next. Okay, next is B XOR A. So next you are supposed to take, this is an XOR gate. For this input, one is from B. I have taken input from B because, look at here, B XOR A. So this is XOR gate. Okay, one connection is from B, another connection is from A. This is DB, and so this is DC. What is DC? C XOR BA. BA means BA, right? You are supposed to use a AND gate. One is from B, one is from A, like this. This should be connected to one is from C, like this. XOR. So why this is B into A, right? So you are supposed to use AND gate. This is C XOR. I have written XOR gate. One more input is from C. The same thing they have done here. This is one connection is from B. Okay, so one connection is from B and one connection is from A. This is BA. This is from C here. So this will be C plus C XOR BA here. So this is how they have written the circuit. This is how you are supposed to construct a binary counter by using D flip flop. Next we'll see how to construct the same binary counter into like up down counter. So the counter should go from 0 to upside means up counter means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Down counter means starting from 7. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, like this. U refers to up, D refers to down. So this is how you're supposed to construct next. We shall go with the next.